a lot of this is are people that just live in denial. A lot of it is poor management. A lot of this is really no different than the White House saying we're going to go from 15 cases to zero, and it's just eventually going to go away. You know, this is something we can't wish away. And you know, everybody wants sports. You know, I get so tired of hearing the arguments from people who just argue for the sake of argument. When people in sports say, we really need to be cautious here and say, how could you not want sports, you know, and all this stuff. Nobody's rooting against having sports. You know, what we're rooting against is some of us have been around here long enough to understand the ramifications of what will happen if this goes wrong. You won't have sports for a year. You won't have sports ever again. Because if, God forbid, one of these kids dies from COVID-19 and you think these universities are going to survive a wrongful death lawsuit when you have to open up to discovery and you have to open up your methodology of why you decided to play football, you are screwed. And you're screwed for good. And the coaches who sign off on it and the athletic directors who sign off on it, they are cooked. So there is a lot at stake here. And I think that, you know, I don't blame colleges for being hesitant about playing. I don't see that as a bad thing. So I would like to see a more coordinated message. But we've known for a long time, Ed, even in pre-pandemic times, everybody's out for themselves in college athletics. You know, nobody's interested in the greater good and the furthering the educational pursuits of our young student athletes. Everybody wants the last quarter in the cushion. And if they have to dig that cushion and have feathers all over the place to find that last quarter, they're going to do it. But Dr. Fauci said this on day one, the virus controls the timetable. And what we're seeing is we're seeing too many people believing they, and not the virus, controls the timetable.